Okay, friends, we are now beginning our castle unit. I know that you are starting to work with Mr. Greenwood on printing a 3D version of a castle of your choice. We're going to learn particularly about the history of medieval castles in Europe, because in Asia, they're not usually called castles, they're usually called palaces, and their structures and designs are a little bit different. But for this activity that we're going to be doing, we're going to be focused in art class. We are going to be focusing more on medieval castles in Europe and their basic designs. All right, so the main structure of the castle is the keep, and it's usually the tallest structure of the castle. It's the largest, usually stands in the heart or the center of the castle. It's built higher so than the rest of the castle, so people obviously could stand here for protection and see kind of from the outside what's going on. Basically, the purpose of medieval castles was protection from invaders, because remember at that time there was something called feudalism, where basically every person could claim, if they had the strength and the army, they could claim land. And if they took that land and had enough money or power and enough servants, they could claim that land and build on it. Now, the first people to design castles in abundance were the Normans, and they came from France. And this was around the 900s. So I would say the 800s and the 900s were the first, or when the first castles were built. And the Normans from France invaded England and later Italy. So they conquered lots and lots of parts of medieval Europe. Originally, castles were made out of wood. But now, but the problem is a lot of those castles don't exist anymore because of fires, and also wood rots. So now, of course, most castles that we see standing today are stone castles. All right, so the moat also was great protection against invaders because it would be a large ditch that was dug and usually filled with water, and that would be an extra layer of protection to prevent enemies from coming or entering into the castle. And then the Great Hall, this usually would be in the keep. This is where banquets were held and people would eat together, was the gathering place. As you see here, castles, yes, although they might have had windows, they were very cold and dark because they were made out of stone. Now the gatehouse would be at the front entrance. And this structure here that you see that is made out of would be made out of iron or wood. It's called a portcullis. It's kind of this grid pattern. And it was very, very heavy. And it was again used, it would go down very, very quickly if they needed to close down the doors again to protection for invaders. And behind the portcullis would be a thick, heavy wooden door, so a second layer of protection. To prevent from people from coming in. The curtain wall usually would be at the top, and these areas here are called parapets, and this is where, again, people, men who would protect the ruler of the castle or the head of the castle would be standing up here. Again, as kind of a lookout, but then they could also crouch down to, so they would be patrollers, but they could also crouch down if, say, an enemy kind of attacked from up above. So it was again a layer of another layer of protection. The drawbridge was usually made out of wood. It wouldn't be made out of stone because stone's too heavy. It would swing up and down like a seesaw to let people in or out of the castle entrance. And this was a lever and pulley system that we're actually going to be designing for our castle design as well. And as I mentioned, the portcullis would be the gate that hangs above the entrance to keep out enemies. It had sharp points at the bottom, so you definitely, if it came down, you would not want to be trapped under the portcullis. That would be pretty bad. The bailey was an enclosed courtyard, so this would be the area surrounding the keep, and this would be an area where they'd have outdoor events or animals grazing. Now, the battlements were pathways built around the top of the castle, and they had little gaps, openings here, so the patrollers could fire arrows through the gaps. And then these little stone structures at the top of castles you often see, these are called crenellations. So here is kind of a diagram of a basic medieval castle design. Again, you have the keep, which is the large building. You have four towers surrounding it, the inner wall, as well as the outer wall. And the keep had four layers. The basement was the lowest layer, the guard room, so we'd have patrollers here to protect the ruler of the castle. The great hall, this is where they would do have their entertainment or the dining area. And then the top layer would be the chamber, which would be the bedroom for the king or queen or ruler of the castle. It's another basic structure. Although these on the sides we call structures on the sides we call turrets, these are a more rectangular cube shape. They could also be conical or cylinder shaped as well. These are some examples of castles around the world. This is the Tower of London in England, very famous castle, and this at one time was used as a prison. And now it is a museum, so you can actually go and visit and see some of the crown jewels and parts of the interior of the castle. Edinburgh Castle in Scotland is built on a very, very large hill. It's got this very, very large circular keep and then the larger structure as well. Mont Saint-Michel is very interesting because it's kind of built on an island in France. It's got very, very intricate stonework carvings. As you see, in order to get there, you have to take kind of a bridge. So this would be great protection from invaders as well, being built all around water. Spanish castles, the stone work is often this orange color because the stone that was quarried in Spain. I'm not quite sure if what type of stone it is, but it has much more this orange brownish color versus the grayer colors you see more in France and England. They have more of these cylinder shapes for turrets around the castle. This one's called Manzanares. Here's a German castle called Landgrave, and what I find very interesting about this castle is on all the turrets, they have these metal, kind of looks like helmets on the tops of each of the turrets. And as I mentioned, most of the structures in Asia, they're not called castles, they're called palaces. And often their structure is very, very different than the medieval castle. This is Matsumoto Castle in Japan. Many of the palaces in Asia have more of these triangular roofs and these stacked layers of the palace building. This one's really amazing in that it has this beautiful red bridge, looks like to enter the castle, and surrounded by a moat as well. All right, friends, I hope this inspires you for our castle activity, and we will be constructing our own castle design using cardboard, paints, and any other materials you like.